here, 18 inches or so high, 2 feet in diameter, sometimes higher, sometimes lower, depends on the time of year, the soil type, and so on. But it's made up of this honeycomb-like structure with tunnels and galleries all through it. And this mound serves different functions. One of the functions is that it provides refuge from flooding. So because the mound is above the level of the soil, if the soil floods, it doesn't get too high, the ants can climb up into the top part of the mound and be protected there from flooding. These fire ants are native to an area in South America that floods every year. So they're adapted to flooding. So the mound is one way that helps them do that. The other is that they're able to form these rafts. If the water gets all the way above the level of the mound, they can float as a mass. Fire ants are kind of greasy and oily, and what does oil do when you put it on water? It floats, right? So these guys just kind of float, all in a group. And of course, during floods, that can be a major problem because you can get these rafts of fire ants, you know, hundreds of thousands of fire ants. And if they hit, you know, the side of a house, someone's leg, something like that, and they start to spread out and swarm all over that, they can do a lot of damage. So it can be a serious threat. So